Hey YouTube, how you doing? Thanks for stopping by. It's Carol Reacts, and we've just been waiting for you because we've got an awful lot of music. We got over 2,100 videos, and it's good music. We pretty much specialize between like the 50s to the 90s, but we take some right outside. A little newer than that, but I'm taking music that was music, that wasn't computerized, or they did start with some synthesizers, using synthesizers in it, but as far as auto-tune or pitch correct, no, it wasn't that. Though, I see these kids with the channels now, and they say, play me so-and-so from the Bee Gees. I say, who's the Bee Gees? Well, they know now. And that we had such good music. I don't know where it's gone. But come on by and search my library. It's becoming a library. Go on in and stay the day. If you enjoy it, please hit the subscribe and the like and post notification bell. We'll let you know, we'll notify you whenever I drop a video. And comments and requests are please. Okay, gonna let you go now because we got a request coming up. We have a request from some BG fans in Edinburgh, Scotland. They would requested to hear Night Fever. Hey, hey.
Oh,
Well, that was Night Fever by the Bee Gees, and this was released in 1978. Oh, what a year. Oh, my God. Ah, it was part of the soundtrack for Saturday Night Fever. And it was closely tied to the disco. Closely? And the vibrant nightlife of the 70s. Yay. The song captures the disco scene and the infectious rhythm and the upbeat vibe, reflecting the excitement and energy of the night spent dancing. The Bee Gees originally wrote the song for the movie, which played a significant role in the popularization of disco music. I think it was, people did go crazy over the movie. And when you sit back and watch the movie nowadays, it's really not that great of a movie. But the music is fantastic. Oh, look, I just don't know what more I can say about the Bee Gees. Everything they write is good. And even the stuff that they don't release, I've come across some stuff that they didn't release that I went into a little bit of a fit because I felt like it was number one or, you know, the top 10. They just wrote so much stuff and it's beautiful. The music is so good. And the lyrics are good lyrics. They're beautiful lyrics. And their singing is, oh, man, nobody can beat their singing. Nobody. Especially during the disco times. They've got this harmony, which is second to none, with the falsettos. They sound like angels from heaven. As far as I was concerned, they were. But I, you know, like I've run out of adjectives on what to say, what to call this group, and all I can say is they're the best group that ever existed. They were, even though they played them a lot, they were still underrated, and especially after that when they blackballed them from the radio. And they only blackballed the Bee Gees. They didn't blackball anybody else. Donna Summer didn't get it. Casey and the Sunshine Band, Cool and the Gang. None of them got it. But the Bee Gees got blackballed. Well, they had to go to writing. That's when Barry started writing for Barbara Streisand and Dinah Ross. Kenny Rogers. And let me tell you, he got hits from every one of them. Barry was just a genius. He was a musical genius, and he held this whole group together. It's not like the others didn't contribute anything, because they did. It's just, Barry was the one that stayed late at night. Okay, well, let's get this posted so our friends in Edinburgh can hear it at 8 a.m. Central Time. All right. Bye, y'all.